Hey everyone, and welcome to TopThink. Today, we'll learn about the science of meditation with a basic mindfulness tutorial. Now, let's begin. Many people around the world know the outstanding benefits of meditation. This age-old practice is one of the best ways to focus your mind and redirect your thoughts. At a basic level, meditation grounds us in the present moment, allowing us to improve our mental health and strengthen our minds. It's proven to reduce stress, soothe anxiety, and can contribute to an increased sense of well-being and happiness. But meditation isn't as simple as sitting on the floor and crossing your legs. The benefits of meditation are well known. However, the act of meditation is commonly misunderstood. We often hear myths about meditation that cloud the true value of this ancient practice. For example, many people say the goal of meditation is to reach deep into our minds and discover new and profound insights about ourselves or the world around us. We picture highly disciplined meditators like monks and philosophers experiencing great epiphanies through perfect clarity of mind. But this doesn't capture what real-life meditation looks or feels like. These kinds of myths discourage everyday people who want to use meditation to clear their minds or improve their mental health. You may assume that you're doing something wrong if you don't achieve clarity or bliss, but meditation isn't as difficult or lofty as it seems. To start, let's think about what meditation actually means. Meditation is the practice of attending to our inner selves and heightening awareness of our natural states. That means focusing on the present moment and, for at least a brief period, relieving our minds of everyday burdens and expectations. For most people, meditation is accompanied by stillness and silence, though these things aren't necessary to achieve a meditative state. In the same way, meditation doesn't require a clear and empty mind. Another myth about meditation is that your mind must be blank. In reality, it's okay to let your mind wander. As you turn your attention inward, your thoughts will carry you in various directions. Some will be peaceful and fleeting. Others will be uncomfortable and harder to ignore. By embracing these natural wanderings, both good and bad, we can reap the many physical, psychological, and emotional rewards of this simple and accessible exercise. Now, before we dive into a step-by-step tutorial, it's important to understand how meditation works and why it's so impactful on our state of mind. Brain scans show us that meditative exercises activate regions of the brain associated with awareness, attention, and impulse regulation. For example, meditation affects an area called the amygdala, that's the emotional control center of the brain, which regulates how we respond to things like fear and anxiety. Like the amygdala, meditation activates brain areas that we use every day to solve problems, regulate emotions, and process information. Over short periods, activating these parts of the brain can improve mood, concentration, and cognitive performance. It may also influence intelligence and physical well-being, though these things may require further research. In addition to stimulating our brains, meditation allows us to practice one of the most important psychological skills for navigating our thoughts and feelings. In tandem with meditation, we often hear the word mindfulness. Sometimes these words are used interchangeably, though mindfulness and meditation differ in important ways. Mindfulness is an awareness of our minds and bodies in the present moment. We sometimes use meditation to practice mindfulness and increase awareness of our psychological and physical processes. Together, this is called mindfulness-based meditation. It isn't the only kind of meditation out there, but it's one of the best studied and most impactful forms of meditation for your mental health and well-being. And here's why. Mindfulness-based meditation helps us separate who we are from what we think. In other words, you're not your thoughts, and your thoughts are not you. In our lives, we become discouraged by irrational ideas and doubts. We become stressed and negative toward ourselves, not because we've done anything wrong, but because we're hypercritical of ourselves. Often, we assume we can't overcome certain obstacles, but that doesn't mean we can't actually overcome them. We only think we can't. Through mindfulness, we draw a bold line between what we think of ourselves and who we actually are. Mindfulness reinforces an important sense of separation, enabling greater awareness of our perceived limitations. By learning to stand on the right side of that line, we give ourselves permission to overcome our doubts and fears. Mindfulness-based meditation can help us achieve and progress, but it's also good for understanding pain, trauma, and weakness. Meditating encourages us to extend compassion to ourselves and suspend judgment of our weaknesses and insecurities. For example, let's say that someone feels guilty for something they've done. Criticism and ridicule won't help them overcome their guilt and self-doubt. Instead, we can use self-compassion to forgive our mistakes and move forward unburdened. Through the lens of compassion, we learn to accept our pain and to treat ourselves with kindness as though we're an old friend or a family member. Over time, this can change how we think and perceive the world, providing clarity about what brings us joy, comfort, and satisfaction. Now, of course, no one can master the practice of mindfulness overnight. It takes some people years to learn how to show compassion to themselves. Like any form of self-growth, mindfulness is something that we learn little by little. It's an activity that needs consistent practice and good intentions. If you meditate while telling yourself that it's a waste of time, then you probably won't gain anything from this kind of self-care. If you give up after one or two tries, then you may not understand why mindfulness-based meditation can be impactful and fulfilling. In meditation, as in life, patience and consistency are key. In the spirit of consistency, try to incorporate meditation into a daily routine. Set aside a few minutes every day to put the ideas we've discussed into practice. Select a time of day during which you can spend at least 10 uninterrupted minutes exclusively on yourself. It might be first thing in the morning when you feel fresh and motivated. You might find the time right before bed while thinking about the days to come. You may not think you have space in your busy schedule to sit around and do nothing, but time dedicated to your health and well-being is always time well spent. Choosing the right environment is another important part of meditation, especially if you're easily distracted. Some people don't have a choice, so they meditate in awkward settings like crowded and busy spaces. It can be challenging in these chaotic environments to shift your attention inward or to ground yourself in the present moment. When surrounded by chaos, your attention is pulled in many directions, so try to find a place where you can be alone. Ideally, this should be somewhere that you're calm and comfortable. Most people prefer to meditate in their homes or in nature, anywhere they can fully relax. So once you've found the time and the space, there are several exercises that you can use to start practicing mindfulness-based meditation. Let's walk through one of those exercises, which you can practice every day. To start, sit on the floor with your back straight and your hands in your lap. In this seated position, focus on your breath. Slowly inhale, then slowly exhale. Try to hold each breath for 3 to 5 seconds. For this exercise, your breath is an anchor for your thoughts. Don't pressure yourself to focus exclusively on your breath, as many try to do. Instead, let your mind wander freely. Let it drift to whatever ideas come naturally and accept them without judgment or reservation. There's no need to punish yourself for feeling uncomfortable or antsy, especially if you're new to this practice. Simply observe your discomfort and any sensations that you may be experiencing. Then, gently redirect your attention back to your breath. If possible, maintain this state of calm for 10 to 15 minutes. If you can't focus for the whole period, that's okay. You can always increase your time the following day. Remember that meditation takes practice, and don't expect yourself to master these exercises overnight. This exercise is sometimes called observing your breath. It's a very common way to practice mindfulness meditation, especially for beginners. What's important about this exercise is that you surrender control and you demonstrate compassion toward yourself. You may think after 10 minutes that you haven't done anything, but those 10 minutes of acceptance and release are more impactful than many realize. As you go forward in your day, those 10 minutes may change the way you think, feel, and behave. Mindfulness-based meditation only lasts a brief period, but the lessons we learn, we carry everywhere we go. Once you become comfortable observing your breath, you may experiment with other forms of mindfulness meditation. For example, some people enjoy slowly stretching their muscles and observing how their body feels. Mindful stretching can help us feel more comfortable with our bodies, improving our health and well-being. The key is to move slowly, be gentle with your muscles, and like before, use your breath as a guide. Each time you lean into a stretch, deeply breathe in and out. It's okay for your mind to wander. Explore those ideas for a moment, then bring your attention back to your stretch and your breath. These are two meditative practices that you can use every day. But you can also incorporate meditative principles in other aspects of your life. For example, eating can be a meditative exercise. Instead of rushing through every meal, you might slow down and enjoy every bite of your food. Notice temperatures, textures, and tastes. Consider the person who made your food and the care that they invested into its quality. With the right mindset, almost any activity can promote self-awareness and ground you in the present moment. Little things like these can change how you approach real problems and overcome mental obstacles. With a bit of mindfulness, you may begin to understand yourself in a whole new way. Thank you for watching Top Think, and be sure to subscribe because more incredible content is on the way.